Diabetes and Obesity Center at New Delhi. Over to ma'am.
Thank you, chairpersons. And at the outset, I would like to thank Dr. Bansi sir and team DiCareCon for inviting me here. So the presentation will be, I'll be talking about the burden of diabetes, role of primary care, challenges, and how to tackle these challenges. The prevalence of diabetes is increasing globally. What we are expecting is 68% increase in prevalence of diabetes by 2045 in Southeast Asian countries, which is a huge number. One very important thing which needs to be taken care of is 3 out of every 4 person with diabetes is from low or middle income countries. So here we are more worrisome for this fact. As per ICMR India data, the prevalence of diabetes in India is 101 million and the pre-diabetes is 136 million. This 136 million people is of more concern to us because this is the number which may get converted into frank diabetes if not taken care of properly and in proper time. So not only the huge burden of diabetes and pre-diabetes, but other non-communicable diseases is also on increasing prevalence. ICMR India study highlights the enormous burden of NCDs faced by India. The high prevalence of pre-diabetes in rural areas is of grave concern. My session is based on this topic. Because these areas, they lack the infrastructure to care for increasing number of people with diabetes and its complications. And these results have multiple implications for the planning and provision of healthcare. In last two sessions, what we have been listening to, it was very dynamic. We were talking of AI, we were talking of care at secondary level, tertiary level, or maybe beyond that. But I'll take you to primary care. In the morning, Dr. Archana ma'am was talking about the disparity, and still that disparity exists at the level of primary care and secondary or tertiary care. Let's not talk about secondary or tertiary. I'll be taking you through primary care. Evidence from studies conducted in India highlighted the fact that the percentage of people with diabetes with poor glycemic control, uncontrolled hypertension, dyslipidemia, and vascular complications related to diabetes is greater than 50%. The poor outcome and type 2 diabetes complications are an indicator of insufficient care and monitoring. And what we have been listening since morning is CGMs, pumps, new medications. But believe me, till day, Dr. Jimit pointed out, doctor was sitting here who's practicing government setup. Many PG students, you must be encountering the patient, the case I'll be presenting now. 3 out of 4 person with diabetes have poor glycemic control. That's really bad. 9 out of 10 live with overweight or obesity, and we are talking of new age drugs. Average 3-year delay to intensify treatment in person with diabetes leads to prolonged period of poor glycemic control. And even a year delay in intensification may lead to significant micro and macrovascular complications. So with this huge burden of diabetes and the increasing prevalence in rural area comes the role of primary care. The primary care is the model of care that supports the provision of comprehensive health care, inclusive of adequate preventive, curative, and promotive health services that are readily available, affordable and accessible. Believe me, they should be affordable and accessible. Primary healthcare is particularly relevant in catering to diabetes-related health needs of the Indian population due to majority rural and large urban slum cluster population having high diabetes burden. So in India, the healthcare delivery is like primary, secondary, and tertiary. The sub-centers and the primary health care, they are responsible, primary health centers, they are responsible for the primary care. And then comes the secondary or the tertiary centers. We'll talk about the primary care. In urban areas, usually private sector is taking care of the diabetes. So we'll be talking about primary care, that is the government level. Let me take you to case study. Patient KS, I am KS, 58 years female housewife. She was diagnosed with diabetes 12 years back, has hypertension, dyslipidemia. She has a family history of diabetes and CAD. She is busy with her household chores. She doesn't get time to walk, and she has poor dietary habit. Like all females, she eats whatever she is left. Dr. A is a busy physician who was, it was pointed out, that patient seen by a doctor is 40 to 50 per day in OPD. So as usual, she is the physician who sees approximately 50 patients. The patient visits with complaint of thakan, frequent urination, blurred vision, and increased thirst. She just has a report of fasting sugar, 190. The BP on checking was 150 by 90. She was taking from last 4 years, 4 mg, glimepiride twice, metformin twice, pyos 15. But she has a concern of weight gain also. So there has been no monitoring, no lab test in last 5 years. I am sure you must be able to point out the challenges. So these will be the challenges I'll talk about. The challenges, they exist at every level. Like everybody pointed out, they exist at the level of family, they exist at the level of patient, the physician, the educators, the health system, and the health policies. We need to work on each and every aspect to give a good primary care. So let me take you to the barriers or challenges one by one. I'll try to be a little fast. The low awareness. Like somebody pointed out, the doctor was not even aware of to check the blood sugars. This is at the secondary or tertiary level. So what must be the scenario at primary level? That is, the awareness is not there, even at the level of patient, not doctors. The ICMR India phase reported that only 43.2% of population were aware of diabetes. The level of awareness was very low among rural residents compared to the urban residents. So here comes the importance of creating awareness. Issues tackling we'll talk later on. So lack of diagnosis and access to quality care. The diagnosis is usually made incidentally. The patient comes with some other complaint, incidental finding of sugar high is there. So the diagnosis is made incidentally. More than 50% diabetes cases in rural areas and about 30% in urban areas still remain undiagnosed. Many Indian states lack laboratories for testing, and more than half of existing laboratories are not properly equipped or staffed. Believe me, I went through a paper, it was telling that even glucometers are in scarcity. We are talking of high things, but at the root level, the glucose testing is not available. And the drugs, what they are available is the usual SUs, metformins, and pios. DPP-4, on and off they are present, but at times they'll give up some brand, at times they'll say it's not available. So these are challenges which are there. Poor medication adherence is a well-documented challenge. What can we talk about adherence when medicine is not there? So first we need to work on the medicine supply. The key contributors to poor medication adherence were medication cost, because when it is not available, you have to buy it from outside, or you have to be in the queues at either at the secondary center or tertiary centers. The regimen complexities, long wait times at the pharmacy, again, at the patient level, emotional well-being, and the beliefs and fear. Even today, insulin, when you prescribe insulin to a patient, they say, I'm talking about Delhi, I'm not talking about primary care centers, I have not been exposed to that area, but they say, if insulin is being given to me, that means last stage of sugar is there, matlab ab sab khatam ho gaya, mere paas kuch bacha nahi hai. So that is the real scenario in this present era when we are talking about so high about AI and everything. So they are not compliant with the diet, they don't know what is diet, and the lifestyle. Because there is nobody to guide the doctors, they don't have time. So the time constraint and suboptimal knowledge among the physicians, this is what we have been listening to. The survey of clinical diabetologists was done, and it was showed that low awareness amongst physicians and non-applicability of guidelines in Indian patients and treatment costs are existing barriers. And lack of counseling regarding diet and lifestyle. The lack of trained diabetes educators in India, it increases the burden on physicians. There's wide disparity in funding for diabetes and other diseases. And lack of integration of mental health services with diabetes care. This thing has also been pointed out. There's no advice on foot care. There's no concept of retina. And we are talking of it as basic management of diabetes. So now, coming to the most important part, how to tackle these challenges. See, urgent government level initiatives have to be taken care, have to be done. They are needed for prevention and management of NCDs through strengthening of public healthcare system and reorientation of priorities in provision of healthcare. Given the need for early screening, large number of those with pre-diabetes and diabetes mellitus and significant out-of-pocket expenditure, we have to pay by our own pocket. We are not an insurance-dependent sector. So there is a clear-cut need for active involvement of public health systems. Though our healthcare delivery, it says ki you don't need to spend money, but they are not able to deliver the quality care which a person with diabetes deserves. So here is the disparity between public sector and private sector. So the Government of India launched the NCD program called the NPCDCS. The preventive aspect of diabetes is strengthened under the comprehensive primary health care through Ayushman Bharat Health Wellness Center scheme. Healthy eating is promoted through FASAI, Move More. It was also a mission promoted by Modi ji. India's 2017 National Health Policy commits the government to investing a major proportion of resources to PHC. The main mechanism to achieve this are 150,000 health and wellness centers, which are intended to become the main points of contact for communities within the public health system. Various policies and programs have been made, but they were very promising, but we don't have a clear-cut data on the outcome. Like the CARS delivery model system was there, diabetes telemanagement system by Dr. Jyoti, training of doctors was done by PHFI, NCD prevention model was there, program was there, Ayushman Bharat was there, but there's no evidence to support what the result we got. So the required public health facilities in India count to about 74150 health centers per million population, but the existing number comes to only half of the original requirement. There is an urgent need to build a well-organized infrastructure and make existing healthcare facilities better, availability of all new classes of drugs. We need to have integration of depression screening and smoking cessation. Importance of diet, lifestyle, foot care, and fundus has to be explained and taken care of. The trained healthcare staff is a prerequisite to deliver quality care and establish a referral linking system with the secondary or tertiary level. The Indian National Program for Prevention and Control of Cancer, Diabetes, CVD recommends training of nurses and as diabetes educator, which was taken by NDEP, which we saw in the morning. Dr. Shashank and Dr. Mohan are the project leaders. So the 10 principles of NDEP are identify people with undiagnosed. I'll be fast. So these were the principles given to those educators. They'll be taking care of. Use of affordable technologies. We should utilize telehealth for remote consultations. We have been listening to telehealth since morning. But yes, everybody is carrying a mobile, but we should utilize these teleconsultations for follow-ups or when the patient have difficulty assessing in-person care. Technology has emerged as a powerful tool, and technological advancements such as CGMs, pumps, smart insulin pens, mobile applications have revolutionized diabetes management. So this class also deserves it. They also need to be given this care. It also plays a crucial role in public education and behavior modification. We should use all these technologies. Universal screening of GDM should be there. What we are seeing is the early detection of GDM, maybe as early as 9 to 12 weeks. Public-private partnership has to be there. To conclude, the prevalence of diabetes in India is alarmingly high and is projected to increase in future. Majority of people with diabetes live in rural and underprivileged area. Factors like lack of awareness, insufficient training of doctors, suboptimal medication adherence, persistent clinical inertia, lack of data for monitoring and evaluation are major challenges in primary health care. There is an urgent need for government initiatives to overcome these challenges. Availability of trained healthcare personnel, provision of essential lab investigations, uninterrupted supply of drugs, training and availability of qualified diabetes educators, availability of specialist support when required are important components for providing comprehensive care at primary health care. Education about diabetes across all strata of society is crucial to tackle the challenges of diabetes care. So in the end, I'll just say that evidence suggests that primary care is the best avenue for NCD. healthcare in the most integrated and comprehensive way. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Kirti, for